I just want to acknowledge everyone's talent before we ever get started. Everybody in this room is able to contribute something, whether you can sing or play an instrument, or whether you have a poem or a portrait or a painting back here in the gallery. We're all here doing something to contribute, and we all have talent.
Heavy chains bound me. I could not move forward. I could only look back at the shame, at the pain, at the dark. But light broke through the darkness, chasing the shadows of fear. My chains were not broken. They were removed, and they hang out of reach on a cross. I find myself free, free to love and to trust, healed of burdens that weren't mine to bear. I rest in his presence. I breathe in his grace, and I rejoice in being unchained. Okay, these are all very short. They're called snippet poems. Proximity. So close are we in space and time. My eyelashes catch your falling tears. Thank you. Fatherless. The smell of sawdust and fresh cut grass remind me how you fixed everything broken but yourself. Eggshells, tiptoe or stomp, cracks the facade, so I dance. Empty. The journals stacked by my bed are full of empty pages and unwritten words, because writing is messy and I don't want to ruin their beauty with my imperfections. Thank you. You guys are good to the snapping. I like to keep it up. Mirrored. When I found you, you were broken. Reflections shattered in jagged shards. I saw myself in you, you in myself. Dangerous edges, protection from further pain, remembered ruin. Sometimes your edges cut me, or I cut you. Bleeding or making bleed. Sometimes our pieces fit together, filling in the missing parts. The next one is an encore. Some of you heard it at the holiday party in December. It's a long narrative, also called a prose poem. The old man sat in a rocking chair, older than he, its seat worn smooth by his mother, lulling her babies and grandbabies to sleep. When he was a boy, he reckoned that the chair was only for babies. He preferred the tire swing in the backyard, or later when he was courting, the front porch swing. But Mama had been gone as many years as he'd known her, and her old chair was his now. He couldn't tell if the creaks were from the boards of the porch, the curved rockers, or his decaying joints. He found a peace here on the old home place, though, a soul-deep quiet that he could never find elsewhere. He waited, feeling the hush of twilight. Each breath was spring, tinged with tendrils of summer, heaven-scented with honeysuckle. A chorus of pond frogs and crickets gave texture to the evening's harmony. Lightning bugs lit the yard in random flickers, making it a field of fluorescent stars as night fell harder, darker. Though he was waiting, he was startled when the sound finally reached him. So long had it been, He was unsure he'd really heard that lonely, lovely sound from the holler. Youngin', his mother would say, get back in that house and put your shoes on. You know you can't go barefoot yet. He heard the sound again, clearer this time. I heard it, Mama, he whispered to her memory. The whippoorwill is back. Slowly, he pushed himself out of the rocking chair with his left hand, the right stroke frozen, hanging from his body like a dead branch on a living oak. He leaned against the porch post and, toe to heel, slid off his slip-on shoes. He made his way down the steps, the once fancy half circles of cement and brick rough under his tender feet. He shuffled off the bottom step into the dew-dampened grass. He shook his head, amused at himself, barefoot at his age. He timidly reached toward a nearby lightning bug, missing by inches. He tried again and again, eventually catching one by luck alone. He kept it gently in his palm and watched it crawl. Light flashed as it flew into the high reaches of the catawba tree from the tip of his ring finger. He danced as much a jig as his legs could handle. Then with a creased and crumpled smile, he climbed back into his rocking chair. He heard the whippoorwill call again, closer this time. So peaceful. He rocked. He rocked. Okay, three more shorter ones. Autumnal epiphany. I can't feel the breeze, but it moves through the trees, traced by the falling leaves that sound like those rain sticks from Guatemala or somewhere, you know the ones? But then something falls between my glasses and my face, and it hits my eye like the closest tree is spitting sticks at me, and I think, what the fuck, nature? I'm trying to find solace here. I told you there was something that would offend everybody. I've always been afraid of snakes, even before I found one in my house. I used to traipse through the woods carelessly, not being careless, but without a care. Yet today I stood at the edge of the woods unbalanced, not unstable, but thinking I really might fall. And what the hell will I do if there's a snake? They like to sun themselves, you know? And I'm planning to sit on a moss and lichen and shade-covered rock just a few feet away. But there's still light shining through the tree branches. For a moment, or maybe 12, I'm afraid of the sunlight because I'd rather be alone than be with a snake. And then I wonder if the snake is a metaphor. And please don't remind me that snakes are good, because I already know that. And once you've had a snake in your house, won't you always be afraid of all the snakes everywhere, even if they are just sunning themselves? This last one is an excerpt from a longer poem called The Male Gaze is Blind. It's hard to see with the lights in my eyes. Hold on. I am a woman, and I can delve your souls, unveil your souls, souls more real than the shirts on your backs or the rules in your books of order. I am a woman, and when I raise my matriarch angel wings, you may not sense the gale within your self-imposed confines, but maybe you will realize that you have never flown. Thank you.
Well, thank goodness you gave me some time to compose myself, you know, with those last three. Me, who never wears makeup, probably has mascara streaming down my face. Ethan, I have got you next on the lineup. You want to come on up and let's get the piano turned.
All right, so this is called Overcoming Hardships. It's kind of abstract, but from concrete slabs to starry skies, from lonely nights to love-filled eyes, a journey of transformation and grace, a story of survival in this race. The streets were my home, my only friend, a place where my brokenness has no end. The cold winds and the hunger pains, a life of struggle with no gains. But in the midst of my despair, I found hope that was always there. A light that shone through the darkest night, guiding me towards a better sight. I remember the first time I felt the warmth of kindness. It was a chilly night and I had been walking for hours. My stomach was empty and my body was exhausted. I had lost all hope. But that's when I saw a stranger offering me a meal. That act of kindness gave me a reason to smile again. It was the first step towards my transformation. With every step and every stride, I left the past and its pain aside. I rose above my struggles that once held me down and blossomed into a person of great renown. I started to believe in myself and that changed everything. I learned to be kind to myself and to those around me. I met people who believed in me and supported me in my journey. I found a job that gave me a sense of purpose. Thank you, Coalfield. And I started to dream of a better life. But the journey was not easy. The demons of my past haunted me. The nights were long and the days were tough. I stumbled and fell, but I never gave up. I held on to the hope that was born in my heart and I kept moving forward. The scars of the past still linger on, but I've learned to embrace them and move on. For they have made me who I am today, a fighter, a survivor in every way. I learned that scars are not just marks of pain, but also reminders of the battles I've won. I learned to be grateful for the lessons that hardships taught me. I became a person who could empathize with others who were struggling. I found joy in helping those who were going through tough times. Now I walk with my head held high, no longer burdened by the past's heavy sigh, for I have overcome the hardships of life and emerged stronger from the strife. I still have a long way to go, but I know that I am not alone. I have a support system that will always be there for me. I have a purpose that gives me the strength to keep going on. I've learned that the journey is not just about reaching the destination, but also about the person I become along the way. So now, I'm not ready for this, so if y'all will excuse me.
You can do it.
So girl, leave your boots by the bed when you ain't leaving this room. Someone needs medical help or the magnolias bloom. It's cold in this house and I ain't going out to childhood. So cover me up and know your love to use me for good. A heart on the run keeps a hand on the gun. Can trust anyone. Man, I'm shaking like my And I was so sure what I needed was more. Try to shoot out the sun. The days when we raged, we flew off the page. Such damage was done. But I made it through, cause somebody knew I was meant for someone. So girl, leave your boots by the bed. We ain't leaving this room. Someone needs medical help or magnolias bloom. It's cold in this house and I ain't going out to childhood. So cover me up and know you're enough. Use me for good.
Did you all set out to just gut me this morning? Leo Pete, it's amazing. Our next act, Elice, are you ready?
Yeah.
Yay!
That was so good.
Good job, Eve.
I have brought a selection of poems that I've been working on. I didn't realize until I got to looking that I have been doing this for years and years, and I've kind of slowed down lately, and I'm hoping that this talent show will inspire me to pick it back up.
Yeah.
This job also inspires me to write a lot of poetry, and so, one. Don't move the dirt from off top of the sprout. There is something it's got to work out for itself. And then don't be so quick to help squirm from its shell, thinking that's just as well. It may not need your help. Clip what's been desperate for love and attention. There is energy then to bloom out from the core. And feel free to mourn losing those that you've borne, a reflection of you, for they do not keep score. Two. The plants trust that rain will come next, and whatever comes next is what it is that they need. And the ants seem to hide just in time from the rain. Suppose I fill a niche, situating myself on the top step, front row, and imbibing. Yellow sky of a fog rolling under the storm, empty bottle for capturing lightning. You guys. Three. I'm a propagation of my old selves, born anew. Every broke and breaking me, rooted loose or deeply in the ground, neatly plowed. A new timeline. I'm prolific. I spill over, over, mended heart, a tempered shoulder. Each note of mine stuck in the ground, water luck and a blessing. Thank you. Four. Sometimes the best thing you can do when you have lost control is a deep, judicious pruning. You will feel bare, but grow back healthier. And I have another one that I wrote during quarantine. I hesitate to include it in my garden journaling because I know that I was drunk when I wrote it. It doesn't seem right. But you guys were there during quarantine. It was weird. So this one's called Peace Seeking. Closer to God out here, butter and bread, while the sweat bees do sambas all over my legs. Just as quick to forget as I am to recall that I do sure the most doing nothing at all. Thank you. I'm sorry, Brandon. Ticking away at the moments that make up a dull day. Fritter and waste the hours in an offhand way.
staying home to watch the rain. You are young and life is long, and there is time to kill today. And then one day you'll find 10 years have got behind you. No one told you when to run. You miss the starting gun, so you run and you run. Catch up with the sun, but it's sinking. Racing around to come up behind you again. The sun is the same in a relative way, but you're older. Shorter of breath, and one day closer to death. Getting shorter, never seem to find the time. Plans that either come to naught or half a page of scribbled lines. Hanging on in quiet desperation is the English way. The time is gone, the song is over. Thought I'd something more to say.
Reprise. To really commend this next act. I think she's been here all of like 2.5 days, and she said that she would sing for us, and I am so excited not only to work with her, but to hear her sing. Leigh, are you ready?
The last time I sang this song was probably almost 30 years ago, and I was standing in a one-room little church up a holler with my sisters and my mom all standing with me, and my daddy sitting behind me preparing to preach, and my mama and papa all sitting on the front pew. I can see far down the mountain where I've wandered weary years, often hindered on life's journeys by the ghost of doubts and fears. Broken vows and disappointments thickly sprinkled on life's way. But I've found the way before me to the land I hold today. Is not this the land of Beulah? Blessed, blessed land of light, where the flowers bloom forever and the sun is always bright. Oh, the cross has wondrous beauties. Oft I've proved this to be true. When I'm in the way so narrow and I can't see a pathway through, then how sweetly he whispers, take thy cross, thou need not fear. For I've trod the way before thee, and my spirit lingers still. Is not this the land of Beulah, blessed, blessed land of light, where the flowers bloom forever and the sun is always bright? Thank you.
There's nothing more in the world I admire more than bravery. And not only are you an amazing singer, but to be brave in front of people you just started working with, that's amazing. The next person is the one and the only Liam Burns.
Well, I'm a man of many talents. I can lie and steal and cheat. I can break your heart to pieces, or I can sweep you off your feet. I can help you go insane, or I can make you fall in love. I can take away your pain, or I can make you hate my guts. Whichever would help you the most. Please don't pity me, but please take pity on my ghost. And I'm a man with many faces, and every one of them's a mask. I sure would like to take it off if I could only find the clasp. But when your mouth is wired shut, all you wanna do is laugh. Call me pretty, call me ugly, at least it's me you're looking at. As I scream from the gallows, don't pity me, take pity on my ghost. I know it's a lot to swallow, staring straight into the hollow. But baby, please put your mind at ease and don't fear tomorrow. Well, I'm a man of many sins. I'm not ashamed of what I've done. I've never bargained with the devil, no, but I sold wheat to him once. Some folks may look at me and think that boy has lost his way, but I don't think I ever had one, and you can keep yours all the same. If it's gonna help you, then I'll toast. I won't pity you, but I'll take pity on your ghost. And I'm a man from many places, but I know my heart's my home. If it's hot like Dallas, Texas, or got that old Chicago cold. And I know that someday far away I'm gonna watch this girl get old. And I wouldn't trade a second for all of Midas rusty gold. No, as I scream from the gallows, don't pity me, take pity on my ghost. I know it's a lot to swallow, staring straight into the hollow. But baby, please put your mind at ease and don't fear tomorrow. Oh, 'cause some men say that tomorrow is a lie, that it's filled with the dreams of a wasted life. But I'll see you on the other side of the dawn. It's coming no matter how hard we may try to keep ourselves in that perfect night. So please don't be scared when you open your eyes and I'm gone. 'Cause even if you can't see me, baby, you better believe me when I scream from the gallows. Baby, you don't have to fear tomorrow. I know it's a lot to swallow, staring straight into the hollow. But baby, please put your mind at ease, I'll be home tomorrow. your mind at ease, I'll be home. Well, I may not be a good man, but the devil knows I'm trying to keep you in the sunlight, to keep you far away from crying. I'm a man of many sins, and every one of them's a scar that's written on our skin and tells the tale of who we are. This song's called Hippie. Head tripping at the gates of the aether, back turned at the dotted line. Eyes shut to the side of the massive, 'cause your head is more trippy than mine. Fall out into mass extinction, disconnected at the jugular vein. Not much less left to squander. Damn straight they're gonna try your hardest to break this up and let the walls come crashing down on your head. It's gonna freak you out as you resign to take the devil to bed. They're gonna run you down around the relevance of all that you said. You better turn this up and dance until you're sure the devil is dead. You better dance until you're goddamn sure that the devil is dead. I got a lot of good reasons to be here, can't think of one good reason to stay. The way you drained every last drop from me, at least you had the courtesy to leave the dust in my veins. Trip back into Neolithic. It's a great day for ego death, my friend. All you wanted was to be remembered. Well, tough shit, boy, the mouths are closed. They're gonna eat you up and let the walls come crashing down on your head. It's gonna freak you out as you resign to take the devil to bed. They're gonna run you down around the relevance of all that you said. You better turn this up and dance until you're sure the devil is dead. You better dance until you're goddamn sure that the devil's dead. Thank you. Guitar solo, yeah. Yeah, you get it, you get it. King's Bane at the tip of my fingers, Doomsday on the tip of my tongue. When you tell me that there's nothing left, I know I'll be the only thing between you and what's to come. Cracked out on the lies of a stranger, shit-faced and out of time. Head tripping at the gates of the aether, back turn of the dotted line, oh yeah. Okay, my guitar's falling, sorry. That's it. So I'm gonna dedicate this last song to all the moms of Coalfield, all the mothers of Coalfield. So, great job. Upon a forgotten mountaintop lay a garden untended and dry. 'Twas a yard hadn't felt children's feet running for. A mother long ago taught her children how to fly. Within a simple cabin, untouched by industrial hands, sat the aged mother in her home. You can't escape the picture frames, there's too many, she says. They keep me from being all alone, yeah. Well, she spoke, he was an honest man. He worked hard to put food on our plates. Yeah, we had more babies than we had arms. We struggled all our lives, but the rewards were great. And when my son came home from the war, he rested his head on my breast. And he said, Mom, I'm tired of being used and grinded down. I feel so low, can you make me feel like I'm the best? Well, my best friend truly wed a savage man. He wore her like a bad tattoo. For his only love was for a bottle. Said there's only one thing left for me to do. To be wild once again and take back my life. I'll run away, set flames to his truck. Well, he won't ever know what he's been missing. I did every day, joy, freedom, dance, and love. Yeah, dance and love. These are the stories that this mother spoke to me as I brought her garden back to grow. I was rewarded with a warm meal, tales never to be heard. Some call it poverty, but they'll never know. She says, all I got's my stories in this old guitar. My crops have all come and gone away. I got a head full of recipes enticing to the taste and a lacking to wake up and greet the day. Bad back from raising my children, from hugging my husband so tight. Hell, I never cared much for any government, but I got my Jesus when I feel the time is right. Singing, I'm the richest I'll ever be. I embrace the world I have all around me. So sing a dying song and slap your knee. Have a taste of true.
All right, what's going on, guys? Tanner Kitchen, Garrett Smith here with the Highwall Crew. Just gonna play a quick little original song for you. It's called Ghost One. She's laying in the sun. She likes having fun. She's gonna take over the world someday. Bloodshot flying kites. You know I wouldn't much oblige, but that shit gives me the shape. And I watch the world melt under our crooked toes, and I felt tranquility, not knowing where to go. You radiate confidence, and well, I trust your common sense will get us where we need to go. I've been working on my cardio to keep up with God only knows what's running through your head. Prescription silhouette, translucent orange wreck, feeling better when summer rolls around. And I felt the world mess up under neatly folded clothes, and I'm counting ceiling tiles from the peak of my crooked nose. And well, I wanna love you this much I know, but sometimes I just don't know how. But sometimes I don't know how. Thank you, guys.
Awesome. Could this day get any better? Josiah, can it get any better? You're next.
I wrote this song a long time ago. I don't even remember how many years ago now. We were on the farm, and we were there for like a month, which sounds out of context, like not a big deal, but we didn't have running water, and we had to kill squirrels to eat and things like that, so it was a fun month.
Typical day out.
And we got to write a lot of songs during that time. Jess, our sister, did, and I wrote this one, and Jake wrote some. But this song's, for me, it was and is about finding answers to my soul's questions and Jesus finding me.
dragging my feet through this rushing snow. Think of how bitter cold a spear to pierce a side. And I hang my head and cry. I've been walking through a dream where everything in me is as it should be. Now I'm awake and trouble's on my back now. On my back now, trouble's on my back now. On my back now. Why my heart is not my home, a fire in a foreign soul. But they say, yes, I hear tell that you know me well, even better than myself. Can you save me from my troubles on my back now? On my back now, troubles on my back. On my back now. Of a dead end sea, and my hate, my fear, my greed, they wish to cover me, but I'll walk no more this dream. It's not my way to be, not my way to be. You take my troubles off my back now, off my back now, troubles. Off my back now, off my back now, and on your back now. They're on your back now, troubles on your back now, and off my back now.
everybody give a big hand for Chris Williams.
So I'm gonna read a little something that I wrote actually in my madness about 2 years ago. Got 7 months and 2 days clean today by the grace of God. So this is called Cause and Effect. Silent whispers of my past, fallen angels upon my path, light versus darkness, bittersweet tears in thine eyes, violent lies, sick of naked demise, underestimated, interrogated to the shadows of the world, broken again, shattered hearts, spiraling circles in the dark, fire and flame, but no one else to blame. Built for a purpose, let my effects of my own choices become something I had once left. Spy of the dragon, seeking to destroy thy mind. Sacred cross, feeling loss. Switch the script, whispering lips. Wind of hope, sunshine of grace, we must win the race. Shattered plains, fields of saints, poppies raised, hazy days set upon a blaze. Drowning in sorrows, looking for a better tomorrow. Filtered waters, forgive me, Father, for my anguish, splintering sin. Dissembled foundation, cures for the nations. Fallen reins, shattered horse. Simple voices, devilish choices. Deviation of pain. Shattered lights, savage nights, foolish fights, treading on, treading on ice. Cracks upon the river begin to shiver. Quake of disaster, demonic perspectives, call upon the protective. Stop feeding the distorter, watch as my skin begins to boil and burn. Satan's eyes start to turn me from right to wrong, like he's been trying to all along. Not alone, just gotta pick up the phone and call upon home. Two stones, one stone for cause, one for effect. Stone of cause becomes a rocky foundation, cracking feeling, shattered heart, torn apart, broken healing, splattered shard. The devil is listening, starts to get you unlisted, starts a spiritual attack of bliss. He shuts you off to spiritual blessings, gets you off to the high of light, to the high of life. Brings you false hope, and brings you darkness of the dope. You begin to get foolish and bound by false hope. But did he really shut you out when there was a stone of effective hope? As he sees the door crack open, he hears a man speak, open, open, open. Do not shut me out. You are just weak and broken. You just need to let the death door close, and you're just being opposed to the holy throne. As he hears the voice, he begins to wander.
About a year after I came back to Huntington, after being in the northern part of the state, I was full of just sort of energy and ideas. I had just graduated from university, and I wanted to test out what I thought would be solutions to help Appalachia. And the more I got into the fight of that, the more it was really tough, because the poem before did a beautiful job of outlining a lot of those factors of just, there's no tangible enemy to fight. I can't like punch it and hit it. It's just the nebulous other of sort of dilapidation and depression and dismay. And so how do you wage war against that? It's tough. It's tough not to know how to know your enemy, how to defeat your enemy. And oftentimes it's who's in the mirror, you know? And so this is me sort of wrestling with that and trying to come to terms with that. And hopefully it works out okay. Thank you.
archipelago, mountains in the sky. Let me watch the world churn below, test my skills against a set of self-inflicted blows, creating in my mind a sort of a synthetic hero. What's your name? Come and settle this score. Can I reckon with death? Can I know you more? Hold my heart and keep my soul. Round and round and round I go. Build my fortress within your walls. One by one. Always fall. Hold my heart and keep my soul. On and on and down it goes. Give me an enemy, some mighty foe. 'Cause on and on this mundanity grows.
Sorry for getting emotional.
Okay, so I have been involved with a program called Surf Day Art Theater since it started in 2001. I was 16, so long ago. But it's kind of what it sounds like it is. It's a circus arts program. If you've heard of like Cirque du Soleil, it's kind of like that, except right now, for example, we have about 200 students in Portsmouth, Ohio, that do this kind of stuff.